Dr. James Pinkney, he is a board-certified family medicine physician. Dr. James studied general surgery at the prestigious Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles after graduating from Baylor College of Medicine right here in Houston. He's the founder and CEO of something called Diamond Physicians. It's a concierge medical practice focused on the patient-physician relationship. Diamond bypasses the cumbersome and inefficient middlemen, the people I call the traitorous insurance companies, to deliver personalized, high-quality medical care to the valued clients. Dr. James, Happy New Year. Welcome back to the Voice of Texas.
Hey, good morning. Happy New Year.
All right, let's talk about what Mr. Brill was talking about and also highlight what's coming up with Obamacare in the new year. First off, address this notion of what he's talking about. Yes, there are more people being covered, but they're being covered and they're being the taxpayers are the ones doing the covering and the taxpayers are being soaked.
You know, that's exactly right, and it's very unfortunate. Insurance premiums will rise on average of 87%, and we're paying for a very subpar product. So the government has promised to pay the five major payers, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Aetna, Humana, United, and Cigna, $2 trillion over the next decade in subsidies for the Affordable Care Act insurance plans. And unfortunately, no doctors are accepting these plans. So yes, we have 15% of the population with access to health insurance, but they don't have access to health care. So it makes no sense.
Could we not have solved this by coming up with something called catastrophic loss insurance and maybe put a rider on there for two office visits a year? And you and I both know the catastrophic losses is incredibly inexpensive, and for those who couldn't afford that, then some federal subsidies could have been worked out for those who wanted insurance but couldn't afford insurance, and some kind of a basic plan that would have allowed them to get the to not go broke if they got sick. Wouldn't that have worked out better than what we saw with Obamacare?
Yeah, that is the best way to insure our nation. We need to use our medical insurance more like we use our car insurance or our home insurance. You have a catastrophic plan, so if you have a motor vehicle accident, if you need surgery, if you have cancer, you're covered with a very low premium, high deductible plan. So if a faucet breaks in your house, you don't make an insurance claim with your home insurance and pay a 1% deductible. You call a plumber and you pay cash. The same principles will work with medical insurance. Why we don't do that, I don't know.
Dr. James Pinkney of Diamond Physicians, my guest right now. Let's talk about the employer mandate that was delayed unconstitutionally and unlawfully by the Obama administration for 1 year, and that's coming into force this year. What do you see as a consequence of the implementation of the employer mandate?
Well, we've got 5.6 million small businesses that will be blindsided by the Affordable Care Act. You've got insurance premiums rising from 80 to 100% for businesses with less than 50 full-time employees. And that's a big hit. So if you're paying, $200 per employee, that's going to raise almost $180. I don't know what type of small business can tolerate that kind of hit. I own a small business, and I know I cannot afford to insure my employees.
So are we looking at a fresh round of layoffs in the new year?
Unfortunately, that's the only thing that's going to help sustain these increases in cost. The other point is, when you have a 50-year-old employee and a 30-year-old employee, potential employees, the cost to employ the 50-year-old is dramatically more expensive than the cost to employ a 20- or 30-year-old. So now you could have discrimination in the workplace.
Mm. Well, what we've pretty much gone through the first couple of minutes of the interview and outlining that we all know Obamacare is not the solution to our medical problems here in the country. So let's focus on some solutions. And I know that your business, Diamond Physicians, Dr. James, this is a solution, at least the way I look at it. It takes government out of the equation and centers on the doctor and the patient. Tell us your vision for the future of where medicine needs to go so it is affordable, accessible, and we keep that level of innovation at a high level where it needs to be for research and development.
Right. You know, we're spending 17% of our GDP on health care expenditures. That is unsustainable, and our country will go bankrupt if we don't make a change. So what I've done with Diamond Physicians, we've completely cut out the insurance payers. We charge a monthly fee, anywhere from $45 a month for children. Adults are $95 to $295, and it includes unlimited visits, no copay, 24-hour access to your doctor. You have our cell phone number. You can email us. You can text. We can even FaceTime or Skype. And then you receive all your acute medications and all your acute procedures. So if one of my clients has a stomach bug and they need IV fluids and some nausea medication, it's included. If you need a steroid shot, it's included. If you cut yourself in the middle of the evening and you need stitches, you come to our office. We stitch you up. It's all included. You don't have to go to the ER or the urgent care and pay prices that are inflated 1,000%. We offer discounts for labs and imaging 80 to 90%. MRIs are $400 instead of $5,000. This is the way we're going to lower the cost of health care in this country. We have to practice fiscal responsibility, stop inflating prices, and inject pricing structure into the market. A free pricing structure, free market, competition.
Doesn't Obamacare work against your model because it requires folks to have insurance, and what you're talking about is not is not insurance as we know it. You're basically contracting your services. So doesn't Obamacare undermine your ability to make this fly?
Well, one of the pieces of our plan that's extremely important is that catastrophic insurance plan. And unfortunately, the Affordable Care Act has driven prices up tremendously for our catastrophic plans that we pair. So we'll have a client that will pay, you know, $95 a month for our services. And 3 years ago, I used to be able to put them on a catastrophic plan, you know, $6,000 deductible for $80 a month. That no longer exists. So that same plan is going to cost around $220 a month. So that is tough. But we are making do, and clients are absolutely loving our service. And we actually have a plan for small businesses as well.
Well, you know, I call them the traitorous insurance companies for a reason, because these insurance companies got in bed with Barack Obama and decided to force us to buy not only their product, but a more expensive version of their product. And the insurance companies are making money hand over fist, and we have the Democrats and Barack Obama to thank for this. And they're making so much money that they have pledged, the insurance companies now, have pledged to fight Republican efforts to curtail or roll back Obamacare. What does that tell you about the insurance carriers? Are they businesses in the traditional sense, or have they just gone to the ranks of the crony capitalists and have decided that they are going to suck off the public teat, if you will?
Yeah, insurance companies want one thing, and that's to make money. They want high profit margins. Aetna made $653 million in the third quarter of 2014. You know, that's a lot of money. And their inflated prices are ridiculous. They are not in it for the American people, so we have to change. And that's what we've done at Diamond Physicians. We've got a program for small businesses where we go back to the way things were done in the 70s and 80s. We go back to medical underwriting. We put these businesses on a catastrophic plan for their employees. We give them Diamond services for under $150 a month, and all of their employees have access to a doctor 24 hours a day. They don't have to go to the ER and the urgent care for simple things that can be handled in the outpatient setting. And we have to implement these programs across the nation, or we're going to continue to waste trillions of dollars.
All right, Dr. James Pinkney, the second. He's a board-certified family medicine physician, and he is the purveyor of Diamond Physicians. How many cities are you guys in right now, just out of curiosity?
Right now, we are in Dallas. We have an office opening in Frisco. I've got a lot of interest in Houston, Corpus Christi, Los Angeles, Chicago, New York, Miami, North Carolina. So,
well, man alive, when you get down here, will you please let us know, for crying out loud? Houston can use you, buddy. I appreciate it. Dr. James Pinkney II, always a pleasure.